Let us create our first Android Studio project. So for that, what we need to do is we need to select the option of start a new Android Studio project. Just click on this one. And here we have a create Android project. So this window, we can select the application name. The application name is your app name. So you can choose a best name for your app. So for this demo, for this project, we'll be using my blog. That's good enough. And if you want to change it to any of your preferred name, that you are welcome, and you can always go and change to your application name as you wish. And the second thing we have to take note is a company domain name. If you own any of your domain name, that is good enough, and you can always use that one to have a unique package name for you. But for this project, what we'll be doing is that we will use a demo.com, as we are only building off for demo purpose. If you actually want to publish this app to a Play Store, then you need to find some good name, a good domain name or a unique name for your app. So for current, we'll be using demo.com. And the next option is a package or a project location where you want to store your project file. By default, I'm setting it to documents and the my blog folder. If you want to change it to any other location, you can always go over here, just click, and you can always change it. So if you want to change it, you can just go over here and you can select any of the file or the folder that you want to store your project. So I'll just cancel it. And the package name, you can see com.demo.myblog, which is a reverse of com.demo.myblog. So it's the reverse order. So package name should be a unique one if you want to publish your app to Google Play Store. So it must be a unique one. If it conflict with other developer, or if it conflict with any other app, then the Play Store will not accept it. So make sure that if you want to publish the app to the Play Store, we need to have a package name of unique. If you want to edit, you can just go and edit it. And we select just next over here, and select the form factor and the minimum SDK. So the minimum SDK that we want our app to get installed, if you target of Android version 21 or Android Lollipop, then your app will not be get installed on the device that has lower version of Android than Android Lollipop 5.0. So that you need to take note on that one. So it will be possible to install on the greater version of Android version than you target over here, but it will not be possible to download on the phone that is targeting, that the phone has, if the phone has lower version. Let's say if the phone has KitKat, which is 4.4, then the phone will be not be able to download and use your app. So just take note on it. Then I'll be targeting Android version 5.0, because nowadays I think all of the manufacturer is shipping with at least Android version Lollipop or 5.0, and I think below than the Android Lollipop, and I don't think any manufacturer is producing any device on it. So it's good to select Android Lollipop, and we'll just select next over here. And here is the activity or default template that Android Studio provide to us, and we can always select any of the template over here. But for now, what we'll do is we'll select an empty activity and we'll do everything from scratch. So just select the empty activity over here and click on next, and here create a new empty activity. The activity name is my activity. This will be also your Java class file name. It will be a empty activity, or you can always change any other preferred name that you prefer, but by default it will be a main activity, and that will be also your class name. So if you change any of these, the class name will also get changed. And the layout name here is an activity underscore name, which will be our design file where we'll be designing all of our buttons and the text box. Everything will be on a layout. So layout file name is activity main. So let's select the default over here, and if you want to go and change, that is up to you. But if you want to follow me, then it's better you keep as is my one. So click on finish over here. So it will take us just a few seconds to open our project over here. It's saying loading our project, and for the first time it may take some time, and even it will go and download some of the required plugin like a Gradle build, and it may take a few minutes to download all of this file. So if you are doing it the first time, then it may take a bit longer time. So as you can see, okay, so let's select and allow access over here, and you can see it's going and building of the project over here. But this is not my first time, and I have already downloaded some of the required options. That's why it's taking a bit of faster time than as usual. But if you are doing it for the first time, then it will go and download some of the required plugin, so it will take a bit longer time. Be patient and keep waiting for a few minutes at least, so all of your projects should be built up and be ready for use. I'll be back when it's done. Now you can see we have successfully completed for our project or app, and that means it's good, and you can see everything is running up and up, and we have a first hello world project, and you can see our activity, main activity, which is our class main activity. So here you can see in a Java, if you go to a Java and go to com.demo.myblog, and you can see my activity over here. And for this file, which is in our layout file, you can always go through the rest over here and select the layout, and we have one file for our layout, which is an XML file. If you go and see the text, it's an XML file. So our project is up, and that's good. And the next thing what we need to do is we need to run our project to test in our device. So for that, we need to add a virtual device, Android virtual device. So on the next lecture, we'll go and see how we can install and configure our Android virtual device, and we'll go and run our first app. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, have a great day.